Okay, friends, to get started with our kente cloth, first thing we're going to do is take our ruler. We're going to line it up at the edge of our paper. And carefully draw a straight line. Then I'm going to move my ruler over. I'm going to line it up with that first line I drew. I'm going to check and make sure it's nice and straight. Then I'm going to draw another line. Then I'm going to move my ruler over, line it up, draw another line. And I'm going to do this all the way down my page. And that's going to give me some nice, evenly spaced stripes that I can use to make some patterns. Okay, now I'm ready to add my patterns. Today we're going to use crayons to make our patterns. So I'm just going to start the top of my paper, and I'm going to draw some simple patterns. I'm going to start with some circles in pink, then I'm going to grab purple and maybe add a line in between. Maybe I'm even going to go back, put a little yellow dot in my circle. And we're going to spend the whole class today just coming up with patterns. So your challenge for this assignment is going to be to come up with as many patterns as you can. I want you to come up with at least 3 rows of different patterns. I've got 1, 2, 3. I also want to challenge you to use a white crayon. I know you can't see what I'm drawing, but we're going to paint over these next time. And when we paint, this white crayon is going to show up and resist that paint. When you're using a white crayon, make sure you're pressing down really hard, because that's going to make the resist work better when we paint it. If you have 1, 2, 3 patterns, then you can start repeating. If you want to challenge yourself to come up with 4 or 5 patterns, that would be great too. Kente cloth is known for having lots of really cool patterns, a big variety of patterns. Okay, friends, my patterns are all finished. Now it's your turn. Have fun, amazing artists.